Hey, Crypto Growth Fam, how's it going? This is your host, Shazib, signing in. We're back with another video, guys. In this video, we will be discussing Velo Labs Transparency Unlocked. It's going to be an interesting one, guys, so make sure to watch till the end. And folks, for those of you who are new to the channel, we primarily discuss utility coins and potential gems. If you're interested in any of that stuff, then subscribe the channel and hit the notification icon for regular videos. And you can also support the channel by becoming a Patreon, so do check that out as well, only if you're interested. And folks, keep your assets safe, and for that you guys can check out the Crypto Growth exclusive discount offer on Decent. Decent is convenient, safe, and secure. You can check out their biometric wallet, which has got a phenomenal $50 off. And you can also check out their biometric wallet 2x package, guys, which has got an astonishing $129 off, only if you follow the link in the description box below. By the way, folks, Decent supports 3,000 plus of your favorite coins and tokens, and it supports 50 plus blockchain mainnets, including our favorite Stellar. So do check out Decent and be safe. I personally prefer storing the assets in a cold hardware wallet. Anyways, guys, now let us look into the price and chart of Velo at the time of the recording, guys. Let's see what Velo has been up to lately. So guys, this is the early chart. In the early, we can see that Velo is still up 244.77%. Decent gains, guys, but it is way down since its yearly highs, almost 3 cents. It dipped significantly, and now I think it is in an accumulation phase, and let's see how it goes. Would this crucial support sustain? The 1 cent mark remains a crucial support. I've told you time and again that this is a psychological level, guys. Whenever a zero is killed, it becomes a bit difficult to gain it back or add it back. It might do it for a while, like it has done over here, 0.0098. Even it might go to 0.008, but eventually it goes back up. And whenever that zero is added back with vigor, with energy, it becomes really, really difficult to kill it back as well. So this goes both ways. But overall, guys, it's still up in the early chart. If you look at the all-time chart, it is really undervalued. It is still down 97.37%. And guys, with the bloodbath in the market, Velo has been down in the monthly. It is down 34.22%. The entire market has been red almost in the last 7 days. It is up 12.32%. So yeah, in the last 7 days, it has rebounded from that 1 cent mark. It went all the way to 0.013, and it is correcting again. In the last day, guys, it is down 3.08%. But according to Crypto Girl, Velo is gaining momentum, solidifying its support at 1 cent with strong volume, likely reaching our 0.025, almost 2.5 cent target sooner if BTC remains bullish. Historical data shows up to 9x profit potential in similar scenarios. So let's see how it goes. This is just a perspective, a technical perspective. But guys, recently Velo team has communicated, and they have tried to resolve certain issues and certain core issues, to say the least, guys. This was one of the most interesting posts that I have seen on Velo in a while now, guys. Check this out. This is from Purate Nature. Great that Velo team explained about the tokens supply on Telegram channel. But I would like to see Velo protocol actively use all social media channels to share this information so the community knows and can repost this info. Not everyone is checking in on Telegram. I personally hardly use it. So Velo has 85,000 followers on X and 121,000 followers on Telegram, but only 1,900 are currently online. So basically, this is not much, guys. From the 121,000 followers, only 1,900 active. This isn't much. I think much more activity on X in comparison to Telegram. Anyways, X is a vital platform for any enterprise project, and all the big guys are actively using it for marketing and PR. Obviously, guys, we know that X is one of the key areas where these big businesses, institutions, influencers, and big projects, they are active. So start using it more, please. Anyways, so this is what we are talking about. The Velo has shared this in their Telegram. So this is Crypto Habibi, Velo. This was just updated in their Telegram now. Many questions about BSC chain tokens. They mentioned here clearly the total supply is 24 billion tokens. Please check, and hopefully this clears the doubts. So those that were having doubt, Velo team has tried to clear this. I really like when projects basically tackle the concerns of the community. Okay, so yeah, WhatsApp, I'm looking at you. Recently they have been good, Anish has been active, but since months and years now, they have been bad at communicating, period. Anyways, so they're taking the right steps, by the way, so we should just spare them at the moment, and let's hope that they rectify their mistakes. So yeah, this is Velo. To Velo community, they have explicitly targeted the Velo community. By the way, check this out. To Velo community, we have received inquiries regarding the total supply of Velo tokens. By the way, one more thing I would like to add. There are a lot of people who all constantly tell me, and I have seen these comments in various platforms, that these utility tokens, they do not need to answer to the community, to the investors, to holders. But that is not correct, guys. Check this out. If it were true, Velo wouldn't have basically tried to target the community, because community matters, branding matters for any project, good marketing, it all matters at the end of the day. Anyways, to Velo community, we have received inquiries regarding the total supply of Velo tokens displayed on BSC scan, which currently shows a maximum supply of 30 billion tokens. We would like to clarify the following points to ensure complete transparency. Number one, token burn event. Until present, we have successfully burned 6 billion Velo tokens, and only 24 billion total supply is remaining. So guys, they have burned 6 billion from the 30 billion from the max supply. The total supply now is 24 billion. And this burn event is verifiable on the blockchain as shown in the BSC scan. The burned tokens were sent to the null account address dead, which permanently removed them from circulations. From circulation, they are gone forever. So yeah, you guys can see and verify it yourselves according to this post over here. I had discussed in the initial Velo videos as well, guys, this issue. If you remember in the start when I started discussing and covering Velo, this came up, and we have already discussed it very, very long ago, guys. So if you have been consistently following the Velo coverage, then the old viewers might know this. Anyways, supply display on BSC scan. Number two, while BSC scan reflects the initial maximum supply of 30 billion tokens, you can view the burnt token details by clicking the information icon next to the total supply. However, the BSC scan has not updated the correct information. Our team is working on it. So basically, the team is trying to resolve this issue as well. So I really like it. Number three, transparency and accuracy. We are committed to ensuring the accuracy of the information presented to our community. We are currently working on updating BSC scan to reflect the correct total supply after the token burn. This is important because people often try to go after the information and while they research it. So the updated version should be up for grabs soon. Cross-chain mechanism. So our Velo tokens operate on both the Stellar and BSC networks. So basically, it is interoperable, chain agnostic in a way, cross-chain. They've got this cross-chain mechanism. The bridge mechanism between these chains ensures that the total supply remains consistent and accurate across all platforms. We confirm that our token supply is not double counted among networks. So basically, they're not double counted, and when they say 24 billion, it means 24 billion, guys. So yeah, each token on one network corresponds to the same token on the other network, maintaining a single unified supply across all platforms. So it is not like that they've got different supply on the BSC chain and different on the Stellar chain. They basically if you count them all together, the supply is 24 billion. So yeah, we appreciate your patience and understanding as we work to update the displayed information on BSC scan. Rest assured, the integrity and transparency of our token supply are of utmost importance to us. Thank you for your continued support. Guys, this is how things should be resolved. To be very honest, the tokenomics is the basic essence and spirit of any project, guys, period. This is my personal take on it. You guys can differ, but I really think that tokenomics matter, and any good project, they should clarify it. They should basically put the word out that how does the cross-chain bridge work, how does the entire mechanism work of the tokenomics, what is the max supply, the total supply, what have they burned, and all of that stuff, guys. So I really like the transparency that the Velo team has taken, and I really hope that it answers a lot of questions for a lot of people. What do you guys think about this? Do you think that by this their transparency is indeed unlocked or not? I would really like your opinions, guys. Do hit the comment box below and let the community know. Anyways, guys, this was it for the video. If you liked it, make sure to like, share, comment, subscribe, and hit the notification icon if you're interested in utility coins and potential gems. And you can also support the channel by becoming a Patreon. So do check that out as well. Like I always say in the end, until next time, stay blessed and stay tuned. Thank you very much, everyone.